Welcome back to the wind tunnel. It's been a long time since we've been in here, but that doesn't mean we've stopped working. In one of our previous videos, we looked at what is the difference between disc brakes and rim brakes, but that was done on a previous generation of bike, the Tarmac SL5. Since then, we have an all new generation, and we wanted to revisit that question. And to help us do that, we have Stu Thompson, one of our road product managers here, to explain how we're gonna do the test.
That's right, Chris. So today I brought two Tarmac S-Works SL6 bikes with me. We have a rim brake and a disc brake. They're both set up identically with Dura-Ace DI2, Roval CLX50 wheels, and Turbo Cotton tires. We're gonna test them at a variety of wind angles and see how they stack up and if there's any difference between the two.
Cool, let's do it. All right, Stu, so last time we tested this on the Tarmac SL5, we saw that the disc brakes were actually a little bit slower. This time around, with the Tarmac SL6, the disc brakes were a little bit faster. With no crosswind, that benefit was about 8 seconds saved over 40 kilometers. With a crosswind, that shrunk a little bit to 4 seconds saved over 40 kilometers. In this particular case, we saw that the disc brakes were slightly faster than the rim brakes. But the real takeaway that we want you to come away with is that this notion and myth that there's an enormous difference between rim brakes and disc brakes is just simply not true. So in terms of aero, you're free to choose whichever braking system you prefer. As always, if you have any questions that you'd like us to answer in the wind tunnel, please feel free to send them our way. Thanks for watching.